Right, here we are, we're in the big keys here. And I've gotten used to how to position the enemy here. So I get, it'll drop straight in. Drop in the back. What you do is you line it up so the edge of the straw is just basically on the right hand side of the wheel. And see the wheel there? It's just on the field. We'll put it in no bother. You've still got a lot of fertilizer. Pipe out. So he's ready to go. That's a huge fucking... Will he make it back down? That's what I'm worried about. Will his tank let him get all the way down there and back? And all the fields have been fertilised by the way up to this point. They've just not been seeded. I'll worry about seeding next time, right after I've finished harvesting them. Normal to the seat as I go. Holy crap, he is just like based on the limit of his tank to get back up there. And see this header as well, I didn't know you had to hold it up before you start harvesting. The first field came right and I was like, why the fuck's this guy not going to hire a worker? I went in the thing, I was looking at it and then I changed tool and it was like, unfold, hold header. What? Press the button and I've seen all the wheels, whatever, fold up. Oh, for fuck's sake. The reason being it's got its own wheels and hitch to let it go in the back of the harvester. I'm guessing because, like, you're not supposed to drive it down the road with that big, huge fucking harvesting head on it. You're probably supposed to, you know, attach it to the back of it and drive it down that way. Oops. Oh well, lesson learned. Yeah, let's see what's in here. Shit, man. 10,000 one swipe of the field. That might actually fill up the tank of the case to do the canola on field, but do it the wrong way. I've got the trailer nice and lined up now. I've had a lot of practice getting the trailer straight. Anyway, now on to you. We race the harvester all the way down and see if we can get back up in time before he gets here. So I can reposition the truck. Holy shit, that's a lot of chaff. I mean, they've got 6,000 just going down. Well, 5,000 to 6,000 just going down the whole fucking field. And I ain't getting... No, 5,000 to 6,000 barley just going down the field. And I'm getting about 12,000, so it's like, I get double the chaff as you get of what you get in the material plant, like your barley. From the field. Wow. Shows you much goes to waste. This is how I save a lot of time, like I do all these different tasks at once. Like I'll be doing this and then as soon as it gets to the last couple of rows, the last swipe up and down, I'll start the fertilizer going. And then once it started going, I'll start the cedar going and I'll pack it up and go to the next field as the cedar starts planting. So I'm not really sitting around doing nothing while waiting for this hamster. And yes, we're fine getting into this. I'm just guessing there's more problem for BP. Like 5 or 6 times I've seen him log in and out of the farm. So, good guy. He's also talking about getting a new gaming piece. QB is getting that all set up and working for work. Quality videos. He gets quality on his own. Quality commentary, which you won't get from me. Commentary. I don't comment very well. I'm not exactly the most subtle people when it comes to talking to people. I don't have much point. But it's simply I just don't give a shit about people. When people start adding dumb to me, I don't have the subtleties to talk to them. I just tell them to fuck off. Stop being an arsehole. I'm being an arsehole myself, like, you know, but that's fine with me. God, it's almost fouled up. I'm not even getting to the end of the next row before this row, so I'm gonna, as soon as I get this, turn around and drive into the pile grass. And he's coming out of me, so. That's when we want to beat the barley through the way I put them, so they're close to the biogas plant, so I'm quick to transport straw down to it, and when I want the straw for the cows, I'm quick to transport straw from the fields there. So I've just been like planning out how I want everything to go, but it's now canola, because I don't actually need any more straws now. I have enough straw to do me at least a week. I've got enough silage to do me at least a week feeding the cows, and there's like 2 million litres here. That's more than enough to deal with cows. And this one's gonna get some more into it. Oh, hello. Yeah. So that, that silage pit is going to get more into it than it's got us now, so that can bring me up in grand total to 2 million. Grand total of 2 million silage. That's what, like 3.2 million pounds worth of silage. I've got to shift. That's why I'm doing canola on there, just take a day off. Just to get all that silage shifted. And I'm also going to shift some of the silage over to the cow farm. And we just get a trailer, like, just take this MAN with a trailer. A crampy trailer. Oh. Hey, buddy. Buddy. Whoa. That's one way to get the parley in. Oops, I missed the start of the light. Whatever, I'll just start the fertilizer and go down to the... Take this up to the next field. I'll take the truck up to the silo and dump off all this barley. And how much have I got in barley just now? 600,000, so it's catching up to wheat just now. So that's when we do canola next. Let the canola build up. Maybe about 500,000, hopefully. Oh, shush you! He's grumping her arse off. And this one's the same as the other one, for parking and workers. See that second blade in? You just line that up with the corner of the field when it's... when the blade is, like, level with the field. And that second rotary thingy on the right there. So this looks like a wee star shape. When it's just touching the corner of the field, when it's the blade is actually parallel to it. Yep, that should be it lined up. Yay! See that wee star-shaped thing right there, that one there. You can see it there, it's lined up with the corner of the field. See if I've been practicing and getting these. I've gave up on driving the roads now, anyway. I can do it, but it's a waste of time. Especially when you've got this many fields and you're trying to hammer them down to do all of them still. Which is why I really want to get one of those time savers like Horseplay and Auto Combine. Because this is. To own all those fields, you could not work more in one day. If one of them was on, you'd never be able to get to them all before the last one started with them. Without some way of having a repeated service running, so you can do more than one field at once. I like driving in cab though, I can see it driving like this. I prefer it to the third person view. But there's only two more fields of barley, and then that's all the barley in. Yeah. Yes, because the corn is in the two at the back. I'm pretty sure there's only two more fields of barley to go. Let me just check that. Barley. Oh, three more fuel, sorry. So, down to fertilizer here. And then we go to the biogas plant and start putting in the silage. I think it was put off by the fact that this Harvester has a much wider head and it doesn't feel so much faster now than what I was used to. So I wasn't expecting it to go so fast. Oops, Harvester. Yeah, I got it at 5 mile an hour. Cause it's a little less than full. But it should be 4 mile an hour when it's normally full. Lovely silent drive. Oh, it missed like 6 minutes. That's not too bad. Put it back in four. There's actually two stages to four. Four has four and four and a half. I don't know why there's a 4.5 and a 4 miles per hour, but there is. See, that's how fucking silage I'm getting. Crap, cause that one's gonna be full next. And then I'll have nowhere to put the straw. I'll just start collecting it near the cows. There we go. This is really something, just get rid of this gold. And if you actually pay attention to what vegetables we use, you can help you get better faster from just about any disease you pick up. Well, disease is related to lack of nutrients. Well, that can be helped by vitamins and certain vegetables. Use it at, oh my god, this guy is bony. Medical. Yeah, I'll just have to go, yeah, around here. Yeah. And he can go that way and I'll go past him. I'll just come down that road next time. I'll give it 36,000 at this, that'll take up to about 300,000 silage in that pit. And that'll be another 160,000 silage from. So I get up to about maybe 500,000 silage in the pits. The fucking pit. Just from all the straw in here. My god, that's a lot of money. £3 million worth of money just sitting in my silage pits. What are you up to, Dougie? Yeah, so that's when we have to take a day off from farming the like fields and just shift silage. Look, there he is, he's done, he's not gonna shift. Doug, just lay down somewhere. He's been a pest. So this is this field done. But that's about the end of the episode and time. I'm not going to do that. Unfortunately, they just take that truck down to the lumber yard and show you the new way of food and get into it. So you can take the even dolly, tractor or dolly, and still reverse it into the train. And hopefully, things go as bad as last time where I accidentally walked for so long, we accidentally under the train. Yeah, this is still the best fertilizer I can buy. The trailer one's a bit more annoying. But from the looks of it, yeah, there's this like wee patch right here that didn't get fertilized. I honestly do not give a shit. Right, let me drop all this off at the silage pit, come back up. Drop off the next field so I can start harvesting there, but it's only the first one we drop those off to. Because it does not matter about the time it takes between fields just now, because I am not seeding them all just yet. And that new hole is just sitting there doing nothing now, because I bought a new harvester, the big case one, with the 45 foot one header on it, so I've now got the case that I used to have with a corn header on it, and it does all the corn, like, and the corn's not going to be done down here anymore anyway. Right, it's only 6 mil an hour we're going up. Right, turning around. I wonder how this trailer gets powered, to be honest. There's no wee hitch bar between the harvester and the trailer, so how does it actually power itself to knock all the chaff out? It's going to have 450,000. That's like 950,000 silage in total I've got on straw. Drop this off up there, ready to the next field. And I've got all these trees here as well to knock down, like the ones next to the field 41. I did some at field 41 to the right of it to let the tractor with the, you know, the cultivator in the back of it get its job done without crashing the trees all the time. And then the ones right next to the biogas plant, just by chipping them. Honestly, those big trees, the open, I may as well just dump them right in the river and get money that way. It's hassle to chop them up and then, you know, chip them. Right, ding ding. Let's see, can I make it to the plant this time? To the lumber yard this time? Right, it has. So, get yourself going at 20 mile an hour. Nice safe speed. Whoa, wait, hey, don't do that again, game. The game freaks out while he's locked. Hey, will you stop that game? Will you seriously stop? Save, zooming me in. It's really annoying. I can't see him going. I really need to keep an eye on these logs as I go. It should be fine 20 mile an hour, it should not jostle them around. And I'm really keeping it road with this because, yeah, I need something flat to drive along so they don't jostle about. See all these trees that keep knocking the camera down, it's not just let the camera pass through. It must be, the camera must be a solid object. There's bouncing off of trees as it was passed. And I also want to check they're not falling off here. That's quite the incline it's been up. That's the safest load of lumber we've seen driven. Ah, yeah, see this old area I was in? You just have trees here. Yeah, not anymore. I came along and I lumbered it all. It's another reason I don't have traffic on. Can you imagine trying to drive along this road with cars getting in your way, hitting the logs and bouncing around? Right. Yeah, so the path I found involves going past Field 1 and around behind the lumberyard. And I've got like 17 logs in the back of this thing, so it's a bit overloaded. Oops. There's lots of trees there I've got to harvest. These trees, they're just games throwing money at me. It's just like, here, have all this money, become rich. I'm going to shape Field 11 to my satisfaction as well. Unless there's like a horseplay thing out there that lets you do that. Yeah! In which case I might stop reshaping fields. To be honest, to our knowledge, I'd hire the worker for the harvesters. Just letting them go up in the straight lines. Reshape the field to suit. Now what I'm not sure of is, do I actually need a field to plant these on? Because some of these tree saplings here are actually outside the field bounds. So was it just a mistake on my part in thinking it needs to be a field? I just got lucky when I... Oh, Jesus Christ game, stop zooming me in like that. Yeah. Then I just get lucky when I turned on the planter, it just turned on while I was at the field. Can I plant them outside the fields, just along the grass anywhere? In which case, yay. Right. I think this is my stop here. Uh-oh. No, it's not. I'm okay. Oops. I thought I'd gone past the little dropping. No, it's just a bit further down the hill here. It's right at the shipping office, actually. I could probably have taken a less roundabout route, honestly. Yeah, I could probably at the cow plant follow the big buildings up past the shop. This will knock all the trees. Back to the front of the trailer. Right, here's the road you need to take off. Big dirt road here, where there's somebody walking along. Don't worry about them. If they're daft enough to walk in front of your truck towing what appears to be over 30 tons of logs, well, that's given the prices on wood, it's probably more like 100 ton of logs in the back of the truck. Right, so here is the lumberyard here where the train is. You can pull yourself around this dirt path here and make it into here by going forward. And this is without having the reverse. Then swing around close to the trailer. Yes, some of them are being just sold just from swinging it around past it. There we go. And since this is the end of the episode, we'll send it. Who put my buffalo there? I put the buffalo down here to get rammed by the train. This is not fair. I wish this buffalo to die. Right, you buffalo are going at the train entrance, the tunnel to the train. Go down by. I want to see what happens when this train rams into you. This buffalo will die. One way or another, this buffalo will die. Poor reversal skills here. Not really. Right, let's send the train off. Let's drive down and see what happens to him. This train goes at some hell of a speed, like 5 mile an hour. Right, what's going to happen to you? Smashed it right in the tunnel! Yes, I thought it was just going to like disappear and reappear on top of her, so... I have killed a buffalo! No doubt when I load the game next time... Oh, Jesus Christ, I'm at half a million. No doubt, next time I load the game... In fact, I'm going to try this other route I was thinking of doing. But, yeah. We'll go this way to get around. Yeah, the question is, will this make a safe logging route? So I'm going to scout it out as I end this episode. So that was fucking awesome! The buffalo got smashed! Buffalo smashed! Oh, hang on, this is not the route I wanted to come. Yeah. Nope, that's full of nopes. There's my route there. Dirt path that I came in by. Right. So the other route I wanted to go by was down here, turn right and follow the main road that way. Okay. Yeah, so that buffalo got fucking smashed. I'm happy with that, but when I load the game next time, it'll be at my fucking farm reset. Which is not fair. It'd be funny if it got destroyed though. That would be nice. Right, so I wanted to come up this way and start right here, so I'm coming down this road. Yep, it doesn't look like a problem coming this way with logs. Apart from maybe the gradients of the hills here might be a bit of a problem, I might slide it back, but otherwise it should be fine. I check my map. There's a buffalo right there. Oh, that's how I'm going to end the episode. I've got to jump in the buffalo. I've got to jump in that buffalo and see actually where it is in the world. That is how I am ending this episode. I am going to jump in the buffalo and see exactly where it is. I should have my beacons on the whole time I was driving in the road there. Oh well, what a shame. Yeah, so if I come this way, it should be fine. There's no traffic at all. Should be any issues. Apart from maybe here turning. Yeah, apart from turning there, that I should don't see or see any issues. Wow, all these trees are just gone. Whee! Look at that, just flying trucks. I'll leave it parked there. Right, we have got to see where this buffalo is. It's not sticking at the top, it's just... It's sending an SOS in Morse code here. This thing is sending an SOS in Morse code. It's like, oh my fucking god, this guy smashed me into a train tunnel. SOS, SOS, SOS. And that's what you get for being a useless PI pile of shite. You piece of crap machine. This is just hilarious. I am highlighting this for the highlight of this video here right now will be going out before the end of the other episodes. This is fucking awesome. It is beeping out SOS. Holy fuck, this cunt's killed. Awesome. See you next time.